Hi, Darla reporting live from 30 Journey headquarters here. This just in. Everyone's bored. It's been almost a week with no social media, and people just don't know what to do. Well, we got a report coming up for you. Stay tuned. People really don't know what to do with extra time. Like, they weren't out here living their lives before. Social media, this is roll the intro. Hello, beautiful people. Thank you guys so much for tuning into my channel. I am Darla, and you are tuned into The 30 Journey. Here, we're on a faith and fulfilled journey through our 30s, and I'm so happy you decided to join me on this video today. All right, y'all, so you gave up social media, now what? Well, first, I want you to think about why you decided to give it up. Was it because you felt like you were being clouded with negativity? Were you not able to focus? Saw that you were using too much screen time? Like, what was it for you? Because that's gonna determine where you should put more of your energy and where you should put more of your extra time. One thing that I did see in an interview with J. Cole and Angie Martinez was J. Cole was saying how he gave up social media for an extended period of time, came back and was doing the same thing. The week that I went away was great, but I found myself falling back into the same behaviors that I was doing before even taking the break. And that's why I knew I had to really extend this one to 90 days. So for you, it may not be 90 days. You may just want to do 30 days, 60 days, 1 week. I personally don't think 1 week is going to cut it. It all depends on the person, but you know you better than I do. So if you decide 1 week is good enough, go for it. But either way, y'all, this is great to actually just to clear your mind and just to start focusing on things, like I said before, that are more important. So if you want to know what some of those great things are, please keep on watching. The first tip, go outside and play. First of all, don't look at me like that. What does that even look like for an adult? Your girl is about to go ahead and do something, and it's not really anything big, but it's something that I haven't had in years. I am gonna buy a bike. Instead of taking walks in the evening, I'm gonna actually devote that time to bike riding. I haven't done this in years. This was honestly something that crossed my mind a while ago, and I was like, why don't I buy a bike? And it might be different for you, because another thing that I will be purchasing too to exercise with is a jump rope. I used to love jumping rope as a little girl. That used to be one of my favorite things to do. This is one of the best times to be able to do that. Start channeling that energy into other things that actually make you happy, that help with your mental health, that help with your body. Keep you snatched. It's summer, y'all. So going outside and getting active is something that you really want to do. I recommend this later on in the day because it is hot. Going outside to play doesn't have to be by yourself. It could also be if you're in a relationship with your significant other. Get rid of the digital distractions. No phone, no headphones, no nothing. Just you and that person engaging in conversation, getting away, really enjoying what's around you and enjoying each other. And that doesn't always have to be in a relationship either. If you're single, you can do this with a friend. You can always make sure you make time for the people that are most important to you. Like I always say, focusing on what's most important and the people that are most important is most important, guys. Tip number two, pick up a book. So one thing that I always do, and I tell you guys this in posts that I make and on my Instagram and things like that, that I do like a 19 for 19, which is 19 books in 2019. And the best way for me to get those books knocked out usually is Audible, but there's something to actually picking up and reading a physical book. There's something to be said about the things that we, you know, try to discard as old, because all of that stuff is coming back. I just saw recently, y'all, a post that CNBC made about a school that was actually charging $10,000 to $40,000 in tuition, elementary, middle, going into high school, I think, for children to be less digitally distracted and basically going back to the basics. This school is basically charging tuition to not have computers, to teach children to go outside and play, to actually sew, knit, basic fundamental things that we have gotten away from because of the digital age. This is not anything that I did not see coming, but I think it's ridiculous. This is so sad, but this is where we're going. What's gonna happen is, just like everyone's basically getting dumber by the minute when it comes to Googling everything and everything being way too convenient and accessible, that's basically what's gonna happen with reading and people not really being able to read. And I think just taking away the phone altogether to enjoy reading a book is very fundamental and important. Tip number 3, mind strengthening apps and activities. Always good to have mind strengthening apps. Like, I think a lot of us have gotten away from like the puzzles and, you know, the brain teasers and different things like that that really make you think. I think that's a good replacement for social media or not having social media in those moments where it's like extremely awkward. And I know y'all know those moments, usually standing in grocery lines and things like that. I'm just like, okay, what am I supposed to do? Because I'm gonna be here a minute. Mind strengthening apps are really good to keep your mind and brain sharp, and also, like I said, to help you to avoid the awkwardness of standing in long lines or waiting for an extended period of time. Tip number 4, your monthly to-do list. So I make a monthly to-do list and I kind of incorporate those things into my weeks that go by. And this allows me to really not have so much on my plate at one time. So I know those things that I really want to get done, like some things might be a life goal, it might be something that I know I have to complete within that month. It could be things like doctor's appointments. Like, those are the things that you really want to start knocking off. You know, a lot of people that don't do annual doctor's appointments, that don't get tested as often as they should, just throwing that out there, and doing things that you know you need to do in your life. So I want you guys to really make sure you are taking care of those things that are most important and start knocking those things off the list that you have been putting off for a very long time, and you know exactly what I'm talking about. And also, it is summer, so if you do have a vacation plan, this is a beautiful time to get that taken care of as well and do that. Start planning out things to do. You can even start packing early. I never do, but I know I should. It's just all of those things that are on those lists that you know you need to be knocking off and taking care of. This is a great time to really start focusing on those things too. And the last and final tip is to start a new activity. So one thing that I do want to do that I have not done, believe it or not, is join a book club. Your thing could be joining a new group. It could be joining a Bible study. It could be, like I said, like me, joining a book club. It is a great time to redirect that time that you would normally probably be spending wasting away scrolling. Starting a new activity is a great way to meet new people and to actually put yourself out there to do something to enrich and enhance your life. Beautiful people, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope the tips have definitely helped you in trying to figure out how to redirect some of this extra time into things that are more important in your life. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. Also, please do not forget to subscribe. I need y'all to make sure that you are hitting subscribe. So make sure you join the community on Facebook. I am on Facebook every Thursday for you all, giving you a few updates on the videos that are coming, and also to make sure that you are interacting with each other, because that's why I'm making the community. It's not just for me, guys, it is for you too. So I do have another video coming soon about, you know, us becoming more of a community and actually putting some things out there for you guys. So please make sure that you are following me there and like the Facebook page. The link is below. Guys, as always, remember to keep God first and to stay winning spiritually. Peace.